people, what's up? Here at Laguna Seca, like I promised in the last video, we have to wear masks 6 feet apart, cars 8 feet apart. My goal is to get under 150. I got new tires, obviously. I got the rotor over hub conversion with slotted and drilled rotors in the front. I got the Laguna pipes on, got my headlights all ready to go. And the car's obviously tuned like it wasn't last time. It was on a base map. So things should be great. Not seeing much in the way of oil leak from the pan I was worried about last time. A little concerned about it, but I'll have to redo it before I come back. But other than that, next time you see me, I'll be on track. Oh yeah, it's been so long. I am so excited. Unfortunately, after two laps, I got sound violated, 94.2 decibels, so much for Laguna pipes. Have to let off the throttle, just like before, as if they weren't even on, unless they have another decibel meter somewhere, I don't know. Saw someone spin out of turn six like I did last year, but even with more pizzazz, but as you saw, the video just decided to stop recording 6 seconds in. I don't understand. So hopefully that's not going to happen this time.
Daddy's first. Look at Daddy's first. Oh, there's Daddy in the front.
All right, so last run I got a 153.246. So that's my fastest time on the trip. Guys, all in all, it was a great day. It was really fun. I haven't been there in over a year. I had a blast and I knew I was pushing my car to the limit based on what it currently could do. 152.889 was my ultimate best time today. And you know, that's not what I wanted, but it's definitely better than by 2.5 seconds off my old time. So that's a huge improvement. The two things that were limiting me, number one, brakes. I have to hand it to these power stop rotors. They are great and they don't overheat. So they weren't warping at all. So that wasn't a worry at all, thankfully. One thing that did happen, unfortunately, was my proportional valve started leaking really bad. So it basically failed. And my master cylinder has developed a leak between it and the brake booster. So definitely squishy brakes the entire time. Definitely had to use downshifting to help me stop. That wasn't good. That definitely added seconds to my time overall each lap. Second of all, I need an oil accumulator. The Moroso pan is great, but it doesn't, on left turns, it doesn't maintain oil pressure enough to let VTEC engage when I'm in the proper RPM and throttle. So that really hurt my exit speeds on turns. It sucks, but that's definitely what was going on. So I need an oil accumulator to take care of that in those turns, those left-hand turns. Right-hand turns were fine because the pickup's on that side, but left-hand turns, it was not maintaining that oil pressure that I needed. So those two things, once I fix those, I also have a rear main seal. I believe that's leaking because oil's coming out of the timing plug, where you pull that plug to do timing and check that timing's good on the flywheel. So that's not good, and that's gonna be fun. I need to make sure the oil pan's not leaking. Everything on the timing side is clean because I didn't see any leaks, of course, like I said. But so those are some big jobs, but they're not expensive. It's just a lot of time. And then I can go back out again with more peace of mind than I had today. So again, it was really fun. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed the footage. And for now, this is Falconator signing out.